वंदे वाणी विनायक श्री स्वामी गोविंद देवगिरी फ्रॉम महर्षि वेदराज प्रतिष्ठान वी आर रनिंग 30 वैदिक स्कूल्स एंड आई एम ऑल्सो सर्विंग अवर रिवर्ड गुरुदेव पूज्य स्वामी सत्यमित्र अंधगिरी जी महाराज थ्रू भारत माता मंदिर विच हैज बीन प्रिसाइडेड बाय पूज्य स्वामी ओदेशानंद जी. I am working with him. Really, I am excited to find myself amongst these great people who are thinking for and seriously thinking for world peace, harmony and security. If we are really to proceed on this way, we shall have to find the solution on so many levels. The first thing which I see is the philosophical level. Unless we find some solution on philosophical level, ethical level, then social level and also the religious level, then only we can proceed in achieving our goal. The first thing our friends have told, that the mind must be cultured first, and if the mind is to be cultured, the mind wherein the violence is germinated, if that mind is to be satiated, then we shall have to follow, as Patanjali says, the yamas. Ahimsa satya asteya brahmacharya asangraha. And at the same time it has been told also by Bhagavan Thagat Buddha as Panchashila. The way of Panchashila and the way of Patanjali and the way of Bhagavad Gita are one and the same. They are telling the same thing. Therefore, for an ethical level, we shall have to encourage people to try on the way of truthfulness, non-violence and other non-greediness and these virtues. This we shall have to preach, one thing. Second thing, we shall have to have some philosophical base also. The philosophical base has been given by Bhagavan Adi Shankaracharya. Really speaking, it is coming from the Vedas and it has been expounded by Shankaracharya. He has given the philosophy of Advaita. When there is non-dualism, there are no two principles, the whole consciousness is one, and we can also see on the scientific level today, as has been propounded by in his famous book, Tao of Physics. If physics has to make any development, it shall have to step in the metaphysics of India. What is that? It is the philosophy of Advaita. We are as consciousness one. And this Advaita has been established by Capra in that book. We can see it there. And if we are essentially one and only superficially we are appearing different, anything done against anybody is ultimately indirectly done against myself only. I remember one very good expression from Srimad Bhagavatam. It's better than Ishavasya Idam Sarvam. Srimad Bhagavatam says, Atmavasya Idam Vishwam. The whole world is nothing but my own extension. The observed and the observer are one. And if I am extended as the form of the universe, then anything done against or to harm anybody is ultimately against myself. And therefore, this philosophical ground must be given in according to Bhagavad Gita, Sarva Bhutastam Atmanam. Sarva Bhutani Chatmani, Ikshate Yoga Yuktatma, Sarvatra Samadarshana. a person who has got the right vision, he will see everybody in himself and himself in everybody. And therefore, going against anybody is ultimately going against myself. This philosophical doctrine must be preached, this must be accepted, and we shall have to think upon this. Now, some questions are raised sometimes as it is required. Or some faiths, it is said that we are having a sense of brotherhood for the people who are of our own faith, but we are not having the sense of brotherhood for the people who are not of our faith. If there is something like this in any scripture, in anybody's scripture, we shall have to follow one aphorism from Bhagavad Gita Vyasa, it is from Brahma Sutra. It is Tattva Samanvaya. We shall have to use our intellect to reconcile the whole system again. See, the words are the same in the scriptures, but the interpretations can differ. And therefore, we should use our intellect to interpret those things in such a way that they shall lead to peace, harmony and security. And that can be done. For so many times it has been done. Even in the fold of Vedas also, there are differences. Bhagavan Shankaracharya, then Bhagavan Ramanujacharya, Vallabhacharya, Madhvacharya, they are having differences. But they are again giving some explanations, and these explanations can be given by using our intellect. So our intellect must be used in a constructive way, not a destructive way. See, we people are having some position in our society. People follow you people. And if you try to take people in some wrong way, you can interpret that way also. But if you have got some constructive view, then you can interpret those aphorisms, you can interpret those words from those scriptures in a very, very positive way also. So we should find that way. Again, on social level also, we shall have to work. I am coming from a village, and I have seen the atmosphere that all the Christians, the Muslims, the Hindus, the Jains, the Buddhas, they were all intermingling with all people, and there was no disharmony. But nowadays, in these 25-30 years, we are seeing that the atmosphere has changed. I myself have been felicitated taking to a mosque twice in my life, and those people, they come to our temple to listen to my discourses. We did not have any differences, but now the differences have been created. They are continuously being created, and therefore we shall have to be cautious about these things. Now, in this connection, I would like to tell one thing. Last week only, the respected Chief Minister of Madhya Pradesh, Sri Shivraj Singh Ji Chauhan, he invited me for a meeting of Anand Foundation. They have created one Anand Foundation, and he asked me what was my opinion. I told him that these all ways you are, these are means you are using, they are useful, but continuously they shall not be useful. Ultimately, people can find pleasure only in Adhyatma, in spirituality. And therefore, what should happen? I give him one term, Sarva Dharmiya Ananda Sabha. We people must come on one dais before our people. And at the same time, we should talk of our religions. And people should see that some Hindu monk is there, some Muslim priest is there, some Christian priest is there, and they are talking the same thing. This people should see. If people can see this, and I said, this shall be Ananda Katha. All people in all ways of devotion, we see, according to Narada Bhakti Sutra, there is one aphorism, Shanti Rupat Parmananda Rupatvacha. If there is peace anywhere in the world, and if there is pure bliss anywhere in the world, it is in devotion. It can be gained only by devotion. We are all devotees. We are having different names and different forms, or no form either, but we are all devotees. And this sense of devotion, if it is expressed from one dais, one vyasapeed, then it shall affect the people, it shall influence the people. And see, there are saints from all religions, they have taught the same thing. The scriptures are rather different. The scriptures are interpreted by the pandits, but the saints have lived those scriptures. This our Marivar Maharaj told in a very nice way, that we are preaching the scriptures, are we living the scriptures? Saints have lived the scriptures. The scholars have just interpreted them. And therefore, in all walks of religious life, there are saints, and all saints have taught in the same manner, with the same words. And therefore, if preachers from different faiths can come together on one dais, and they can do Ananda Katha, and quoting from all the works of religious life, it shall create an atmosphere of harmony, and surely people will follow us. And that is the way to peace, harmony, and security. I wanted to say something more also on this ecology, but I will say it tomorrow.
Very nice.